A very good morning, my dear students. This series, this video is completely just out of your NCERT. It's just for your entrance exam. Here we will do spiro, bicyclo nomenclature, and we will learn about the degree of unsaturation also, which is going to help you in the isomerism. Okay, so let's learn and let's start the video. And just make the short notes for this. If you are watching it, make short notes in for this, because right now it is not helpful for you in the class 11, but sooner you will get it, and sooner you will realize that it is quite important topic. Okay, so as usual, let's start with the quote, and this quote is: anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried something new. अगर किसी ने ये कहा है और कहता है कि कभी उसने कोई भी mistake नहीं की है, मतलब बच्चे, believe me, he or she has never tried anything new. क्योंकि जब भी कोई नया कुछ भी ट्राई करता है तो ऑब्वियसली वन और टू टाइम्स ही और शी जो दैट मेक्स मिस्टेक, एंड देन ओनली थ्रू दैट मिस्टेक्स दे लर्न एंड दे एक्सेल इन दैट फील्ड. सो इफ यू आर डूइंग मिस्टेक्स, दैट नॉट सो थिंग टू वरी मे बी, बट द रिपीटेड मिस्टेक शुड नॉट बी देयर. द सेम मिस्टेक शुड नॉट बी हैपन अगेन एंड अगेन. ओके, सो जस्ट बी केयरफुल अबाउट दैट. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द वीडियो. एंड here is the nomenclature of bicyclic compounds. We are going to learn about the bicyclic compound. As it is said, bi, that means two, and cyclic, that means two cyclic compounds. So what's the new thing? Yes, there is a new thing. You have done bicyclic compound like this. Aapne aise nomenclature kiya hua hai, cyclopropyl propane, isn't it? You have done. So what is the new? Here's something new, is that bicyclic compound, it means that this two ring will be attached with the same carbon, with the one carbon, a common carbon, or two common carbon, or more carbon, a common carbon. There will be the jo linked hai, jo carbon hai jisse wo dono attached hai, wo common hona chahiye. Like in this chain you cannot see anything common, isn't it? This completely a three carbon ka chain hai. This is also completely three carbon ka chain hai. So bicyclo, that means it is having some common carbon. So bicyclic compounds are compounds that contain two rings, and if the two rings share one carbon, the compound is spirocyclic. Okay, one carbon hoga to spirocyclic. Like you can see that yes, so this carbon is common in this ring as well as in this ring, isn't it? So this is named as spiro. ये जो ग्रुप है, जो कंपाउंड है, जो इसके फैमिली है, दैट इज विल बी कॉल्ड स्पाइरोसाइक्लिक. एंड इफ और सिंपली स्पाइरो आल्सो वी कैन यूज. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, यू कैन सी दैट दिस कार्बन इज कॉमन ओवर हियर एंड ए साइकिल, एंड दिस इज द बी साइकिल. और अनदर कंपाउंड यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज कॉमन कार्बन, हियर इट इज ए साइकिल एंड हियर इट इज बी साइकिल. सो दे आर कॉमन, दे आर अटैच्ड विद द कॉमन कार्बन, इजंट इट? Now, if the two rings share two adjacent carbon, the compound is fused bicyclic compound. Fused bicyclic, that means suppose that if it is like this, so two adjacent carbon ko agar ye wo karte hain, they share karte hain, they will be called fused bicyclic compound, like this. You can see, yes. So let's move to next thing, and this is if the two rings share more than two carbons. Okay, in one carbon then it was spiro, but if two rings share more than two carbon, then it will be considered as bridge bicyclic compound. Okay, bridged bicyclic compound, like I will tell you example, like this is bridged bicyclic compound. So this one you'll right now I will give you the nomenclature for this. You will very easily you will do it, but sometime the question can be asked in this way. So now you will think that how it come. So let's see how it is. This is just mark it, okay, or counting. Whenever we do for this type of compounds, now we have to start from the bridge head. This is called bridge head. Okay, ye jo. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Put it like this. Yes. So let's start with the carbon number 1. 1 is attached with the 2. 1 is attached with the 2. Here it is 1. Here it is 2. 2 is further attached with the 3. So let me mark as a 3 like this. Yes. 3 is further attached with the 4. So let me mark it as a 4. Clear? Now. वापस आ जाइए ब्रिज पे, हम आ गए वन ब्रिज टू अनदर ब्रिज, नेक्स्ट ऑन अदर साइड वन इज अटैच विद द सिक्स, सो जस्ट इट इज वन एंड दिस वन इज सिक्स, इजंट इट? सिक्स इज फर्दर अटैच विद द फाइव, सो पुट इट हियर फाइव, एंड द फाइव इज अटैच विद द फोर, सो जस्ट अटैच दिस, डन. एंड वन एंड फोर आर कॉमनली अटैच, सो वन एंड फोर आर कॉमनली अटैच विद द कार्बन एंड दिस कार्बन इज हियर सेवन. So didn't you get that same one, isn't it? So it's very easy. So this type of compound is also considered as bricyclobridged bicyclo compound. Don't worry about that. That something else, something extra it is. Bicyclic compounds are named by using alkane name to designate the total number of carbons and the prefix bicyclo or spiro to indicate the number of shared carbon. What is this? That you will understand with the help of examples. So just wait for an example. प्रेफिक्स स्पाइरो, ये याद रखना है, प्रेफिक्स स्पाइरो. दिस बाइसाइक्लो और स्पाइरो वी आर यूजिंग, दैट विल वी विल यूज एज अ प्रेफिक्स. सो प्रेफिक्स स्पाइरो इंडिकेट दैट ओनली वन शेयर्ड कार्बन आर देयर, व्हाइल बाइसाइक्लो इफ यू आर यूजिंग दैट इंडिकेट्स दैट टू और मोर शेयर्ड कार्बन. मतलब इफ देयर इज ओनली वन शेयर्ड कार्बन वी विल यूज स्पाइरो, एंड इफ इट इज टू और मोर देन नंबर मोर नंबर ऑफ कार्बन आर शेयर्ड देन वी विल यूज बाइसाइक्लो. So here, the following compound, for example, contains seven carbon atoms and is therefore a bicycloheptane. कैसे हुआ? Let's see. This one is okay. Counting as I told you पहले यहाँ पे मैं explanation करता हूँ. This one is bridgehead atom. And बाकी जो भी atoms होते हैं, they are considered as वो bridge के बीच के होते हैं. So they can call bridge element. Okay. So like we can say that this is bridgehead. Okay. And this is bridge carbon in this. In this ring also there are the two bridge carbon. Yes, this is bridge head atom. Done. And here one carbon in the bridge in this ye dusre chain mein, straight chain mein aa gaya. To kaise nomenclature karte hain uske liye samjho. So here the atoms contain common to both ring. Number of such carbon is either one in spiro or two in bicyclo are called bridge head. Kise bridge head kehte hain? Maine bataya aapko ki jo common hota hai. स्पाइरो में वन होगा और बाइसाइक्लो में टू होगा. एंड ईच कार्बन चेन ऑफ एटम्स कनेक्टिंग द ब्रिज हेड एटम इज कॉल्ड अ ब्रिज. वो ब्रिज कहलाते हैं. दैट इज नॉट अ ब्रिज हेड, इट विल बी ब्रिज. तो कैसे नॉमेनक्लेचर करते हैं इसके लिए यहाँ पे देयर इज अ एक्सप्लेनेशन, दैट फॉर्मूला हैव गिवन यू. आफ्टर द प्रेफिक्स स्पाइरो और बाइसाइक्लो कम्स ब्रैकेट एंड दैट कंटेन्स नंबर इंडिकेटिंग द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन इन ईच ब्रिज. These are listed in order of decreasing order. ये चीज important है, आपको याद रखना है decreasing order. How to see? Only one carbon is there, so a spiro for sure. A spiro. Now you have to go for the bigger chain first, bigger ring first, and then we have to go for the smaller ring. So in this bigger ring, you just check the bridge atom कितने हैं. Excluding this bridge head, you have to count only the bridge atom. So 1, 2, 3, 4 bridge atoms. So 4 here. 1, 2, 3, and then what next you have to do? You have to add in this 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 1, 8. So octane, that root word we will write. Why it is so? Why we are adding one? Because in this case we are excluding this bridgehead. हमेशा bridgehead को exclude कर रहे हैं. So that's why at last we will add this and we will write the root word. Any doubt in this? The spiro 4, 3 octane. Another example like this. So spiro, because single carbon is there. Now the bigger ring, so this is in the bigger ring, check the bridge atom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so this is 5. Smaller ring, there is a 4, so 4, and then again one add, so 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, and it is decane. Any doubt in this? Now next is, this is bicyclo. Why it is so bicyclo? Because here it is 2 carbon common, and since again in this also we have to follow the same thing, that descending order we have to go, but in this case both the ring are having same number of bridge carbon. So any from any you can start. Yes, so first 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 4, 4 do ring, and then last mein jo hota hai wo hum likhte hain common chain ke beech mein jo jitne number of carbon hote hain, yani is chain pe jitne bridge atom hote hain wo likhte hain. So in this chain there is no bridge atom, so we'll write 0. And then what we'll do, we'll just add this number and then add at last add 2. Why? Because here in this bicyclo case we have excluded 2 bridge head atom, so that's why 2 add karenge, and this will give you the root word decane. Clear? Let's do another example like this. In this case, this is having so bicyclo because there are the two bridgehead. Yes. And then bigger chain 1, 2, 3, 4, smaller chain 1, 2, 3. So 4 plus 3. And then in this case, in this chain also, there is a one bridge item. Yes. So 1. Again, the same thing. Add all 3 plus 2, and then it will give you the root word. Clear? Now, the next thing is here. You can see that 1, 2, 3, 4 in the bigger one. Smaller one, it is like 1, 2. We should not mark it as a 1 over here. One second. Cut. Here is the next example, that is again, so just mark it, this is bridgehead. Yes, so we will not mark it as in this keychain 1 2, and in other ring there is again 1 2. So we can write bicyclo 2 2, and in this it is one bridge carbon, so 1. So again, add this to all this, 2 plus 2 plus 1 5 5 plus 2 7, and it is going to give you heptane. Clear? Now, numbering in bicyclic compound, it starts at any one bridgehead. Kisi bhi ek bridgehead se aapko start karna hoga numbering. I'm not numbering it here. It's a bridge atom ko maine mark kiya. Okay? Numbering jab bhi hum karenge, to it will start from the bridgehead, one of the bridgehead. Continuing along the next longest ko pehle hum leke jayenge, longest chain ke bridge carbon ko leke jayenge, and then return to the first bridgehead carbon, so that the shortest bridge is numbered last. तो वापस जहां से हम ब्रिज हेड से स्टार्ट करेंगे, हम उसी को फिर लॉन्गेस्ट चेन होते हुए वी विल कवर, विल ट्राई टू गो, विल गो एट द फर्स्ट ब्रिज हेड, वापस उसी पे जाएंगे. जैसे लेट मी सी शो यू, दिस इज द ब्रिज हेड इज वन हेयर एंड आइदर हेयर और हेयर. सो आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हेयर, सपोज दैट दिस इज वन. सो टू, इट दिस कैन बी ऑल्सो टू, दिस कैन बी ऑल्सो टू. नाउ विच विल बी प्रेफरेबल फ्रॉम द लॉन्गेस्ट वन, सो द लॉन्गेस्ट साइड वी विल गो. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And at last, the jo common chain mein jo hoga, bridge carbon, usko hum at last number denge, 9 ya 8, jo bhi hoga. Got it? So in this case, bicyclo, 2 bridge head are there. So bicyclo and how many bridge head? Bridge carbon, 1, 2, 3 in the bigger chain. So 3, smaller chain, 1, 2. So 2, and in this common one, 1 only. So this is 1. Again, add all this and then 2, and you will get the root word. Clear? Now, the next example is like this. Now, numbering is why it is must, because it can have any group, any other group also, any prefix it can be. So, like this, I have numbered. So, see, in this case, I could have numbered it from here also. Yes? What would happen if maine yahan se number kiya hota? Suppose that 1, this is 2, 3, 4. This methyl group, ye jo branching hai, that would have come on at the fourth position. But if I am starting counting from here, it is coming at the second position. So, which will be preferable? For sure, that second position. So, that's why it is marked like this. 1. So, this one is wrong. Let me cut it. Yes. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the last one is at the 8th position. So, we'll write because alphabetically we follow. So, 8 bromo and then 2 methyl bicyclo, bigger one 1 2 3 3, smaller one 1 2 2 over here, and in that middle one this is 1. Add all 3 and then add 2 and you'll get the root word. So this is clear. Yes. Now the next is here again counting. You can start from here as well as from here. Kahin se bhi aap start karte ho. Suppose that if you are starting your counting from this side, so we could have a start counting from here also. So let me start here, from here, and then see what is the difference. So this is 1 2 3. Any bromine is coming at the third position, no worries about that. Then it would be 4, it would be 5 6 and 7. So ye jo methyl group hai, that would come at the seventh position if I will start counting from this side, isn't it? And if जो यहां से इफ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट 1 2 3 4 5 6, देन दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप इज कमिंग एट द 6, क्योंकि ब्रोमीन पोजीशन एनी हाउ इट इज एट द थर्ड पोजीशन. सो वी हैव टू चेक द अनदर प्रीफिक्स आल्सो. सो व्हाटएवर द पर्पल मार्किंग आई हैव डन, सो इफ आई एम फॉलोइंग दिस वन, द सीएस3 ग्रुप विल कम एट द 7th पोजीशन, व्हिच इज which is not preferable according to lowest locant rule. So that's why we have to consider the previous marking, as I have done already. So this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is wrong. Let me cut this. Yes. Clear? So what will be the naming? 3 bromo, 6 methyl, and then bicyclo. Bigger one, 1, 2, 3. Smaller one, 1, 2. And in between, there is no bridge carbon, so 0. And total again, 3 plus 2 plus 2, it is going to give you heptane. Yes. So next is going to be important, very important topic. According to your entrance point of view, according to in this way, by knowing this thing, you can easily find the number of isomers also. So that is called degree of unsaturation or double bond equivalence. This is also DU, named as DU. Degree of unsaturation, that is small abbreviation is DU, and it is also known as index of hydrogen deficiency. Hydrogen ki kitni deficiency hai, that will be measured by DU, yani degree of unsaturation. Or ring plus double bond. This is ring plus double bond. The DU, that means degree of unsaturation, not the Delhi University. Its degree of unsaturation will give you a number of rings plus double bond present in that. Or in other way, you can give the degree of unsaturation by looking at the structure, that how many rings it is having and how many double bonds it is having. Yes. So it's helpful in organic chemistry while drawing chemical structure. So let's know this thing. The formula is 1 plus number of carbon atom, jitne bhi honge, minus hydrogen half. Whatever the number of hydrogen are there, just half it, plus number of nitrogen divided by 2. Other formulas are also there, so we can use anyone. I'm using this formula, so anyhow we can do. Okay, so this is 1 plus number of carbon minus hydrogen ko half karenge, and nitrogen ko 2 nitrogen ko bhi half karke but usse add karenge. Clear? Where C is equal to number of carbon atom, H is equal to number of hydrogen or halogen, we can say hydrogen or halogen, and nitrogen jo hoga, that will be N, will be number of nitrogen. Rules: each double bond adds 1 to DU. Agar ek double bond hai, to DU jo hoga, unsaturation, degree of unsaturation, wo 1 ho jayega. Theek hai? Agar 2 double bond honge, to 2 ho jayenge. 3 honge, to 3 ho jayenge. Like this. Yes. Each triple bond adds 2 DU. ट्रिपल बॉन्ड जो होंगे वो 2 ऐड करेंगे डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन में. ठीक है, यानी कि 1 ट्रिपल बॉन्ड इट मींस 2 डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन. ईच रिंग एड्स 1 टू डीयू. सिमिलरली अगर एक रिंग होगा वहां पे तो डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन भी 1 होगी. अब सपोज दैट किसी कंपाउंड में, इफ आई एम गिविंग यू वन कंपाउंड लाइक दिस एंड हियर इट इज, सो व्हाट विल बी द डीयू आई विल आस्क, डिग्री ऑफ अनसैचुरेशन कितने होंगे. सो ऑब्वियसली एक रिंग तो 1, or 1 double bond, so 1. That means degree of unsaturation is 2. Isn't it clear? So, this is a general trend. If only carbon or hydrogen ka chain hai, wahan pe ring hai to. And if other atoms are used, like hydrogen, halogen and nitrogen are used, so then we can do use that formula. Okay. So, let's do example C5H8. What will be the DU in this case? Just think of it. 2 double bond C5H8, if you will draw the structure, it can be possible in this way, like 2 double bond, ya fir 1 triple bond ho sakta hai, ya fir 2 rings ho sakte hai simply, ya fir 1 double bond aur 1 ring ho sakta hai. Draw the structure and that will give you the number of isomers also. So C5H8, if I will see that in this case, use that formula. So 1 plus C is 5. Minus hydrogen is 8, 8 upon 2, yani ki 4, and there is no nitrogen, so this is 0. So this is what? 5 minus, 6 minus 4, yani ki, this is going to be 2. So what is the degree of unsaturation over here? Degree of unsaturation is 2. In this case, you just check, either it can have 2 double bonds, so here also 2, or it can have 1 triple bond, then also 2, because 1 triple bond gives 2 degree of unsaturation, or 2 rings only, because 1 ring gives 1 degree of unsaturation. So 2 rings means 2 degree of unsaturation. Or it can be 1 double bond and 1 ring. That means 2 degree. Now it will be easy to draw the structure. C5H8. How many? If I will ask that, draw the all possible isomers for this. All possible. Jitne bhi honge. So you just make it C5H8. Yani ki ek aap isko 2 double bond. Ek yani ki ye 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ek double bond yahan, dusra double bond yahan. Draw the structure. like this. Clear? Just check. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and carbon 5. So this is one isomer. Another isomer, one triple bond. Only one triple bond. Yani ki ek humne ye bana diya C5. Or give one triple bond like this. Sorry. There will be no. Yes, in this case. Clear? So here also 8 hydrogen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And this is one isomer. This is two isomers. Next can be two rings. So just make two rings. How it would be like this. This case 2, 4, 6 and 8. Isn't it? So this is two rings. It can be third isomers ban gaya. And fourth isomers. How many isomers are possible? We can make it one double bond and one ring easily. So that means make a one double bond. Sorry, it should be like this. One ring like C5. And one double bond de do. So this is going to be what? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total number of isomers will be given to you. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4. Four isomers can be possible for C5H8. All the type of isomers. So degree of unsaturation is going to help you to get the number of isomers also. Now the next question is like this. Start. So in this case, if I will draw, I'll try to find the DU. So in this case, there is one ring. So one DU, then three double bond. That means it is going to be three. Yes. And one triple bond. That means it is going to be two. So what is the degree of unsaturation? 3, 2, 4, 1, 5, 6. Isn't it? 6 unsaturation. So 6, as it contains 3 double bonds, 1 triple bond and 1 ring. So that is 6 degree of unsaturation it can show. Now the next thing. C6H12O6. Just find it how it will be. Carbon over 1 plus formula is given. 1 plus carbon 6. Hydrogen is 12. 12 by 2 yani ki that is going to be 6. And this is no hydrogen, no nitrogen. So that will be 0. So this is 1. So the degree of unsaturation will be just 1. Isn't it? Clear? Any doubt? So how this DU is becoming 1? Let's see. This is the formula of glucose. Okay. Glucose. So glucose you will learn in class 12th, glucose structure. This is like this. Second carbon, the OH will be on this side and here it is this. Got it? So you can see that DU, double bond, only one double bond over there. So that means degree of unsaturation is 1. Yes. So similarly, you can find the degree of unsaturation. Few more examples I have written here, like C6H12N2Br2. So let's do this. One formula is 1 plus carbon. Carbon is 6. Minus hydrogen upon 2, that means 12 upon 2 is 6, plus minus halogen is also there, so minus 2 upon 2 yani ki 1, and then nitrogen is plus 2 upon 2 yani ki 1. Yes, did you get that? Ye structure aapko ye formula samajh mein aa gaya. This is for hydrogen, this is for halogen, and this is for nitrogen. Okay, so what is that for? This is again that DU is 1. Isn't it? So here in this case also the DU is 1. Now the next example is like this. What will be the DU first? Tell me. No need to go for this formula 1 because ring dikh raha hai aapko yahan pe simple. So you can say that the DU is 1 because of one ring. Yes. Next this one. So this is bicyclo. So how many ring over there? Think of it, how many ring over there? Two rings are there, isn't it? So the bicyclic, the DU will be two rings, then two. Clear? Any doubt? This we have done. It was the structure, isn't it? We have done how this will be converted into this. So two rings are there, one ring, two ring. So that means DU is two. Now a few more examples, that is here. 6 here, total number of double bond kitne hai? 4. So 4 double bonds and 1 due to ring. So DU is 5. Yes. Next example is like this. One ring over there. So one ring, that means DU 1. then 3 and 1, 4, 4 double bonds, isn't it? 4 double bonds, so again the D is 5, 4. Four double bonds, so the DU is 4, that means total is 5. So what will the DU? 5, 4 double bonds and 1 ring. I hope it is clear. Any doubt in this? See, DU greater than 4 or equal than 4 doesn't demand matlab bahut zyada nahi hota, but suggests the possibility of an aromatic compound. It's not 100% sure, but possibility hoti hai ki agar DU 4 ya 4 se zyada ho raha hai to wo aromatic कंपाउंड हो सकता है. इट मे बी बेंजीनोइड, इट मे नॉट बी बेंजीनोइड, ओके, बट इफ इट मे पॉसिबल, दैट मीन्स वी कैन से दैट द परसेंटेज वाइज इफ यू सी, सो 90% चांसेस हैं कि अगर डी यू 4 या 4 से ज्यादा है तो इट विल बी एन एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड, आइदर बेंजीनोइड और नॉन बेंजीनोइड. ओके, सो दैट्स इट फॉर टूडे क्लास. आई होप इन दिस एक्स्ट्रा पार्ट, एक्स्ट्रा वीडियो, लाइक एक्स्ट्रा कंटेंट, यू गॉट द एक्स्ट्रा कंटेंट एंड यू अंडरस्टूड ऑल द थिंग्स वट एवर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड. So we'll meet with some other videos for such type of extra content. Till then, thank you, class.